afford to live in the situation that I'm in? Why would you handpick me to wear glasses? Why would you handpick me to have a body shape like I do? Because he said you're chosen for a certain purpose and for a certain reason. Have y'all ever noticed that? You know when you go to the store and there's items, but they come in different colors, they come in different shapes, they come in different sizes? Why is that? Why do we get so many choices in the store? Anybody know? Come on. You let me. Why are there so many choices in the store? When you go in the store, couldn't Walmart just have one of everything in red? Would you keep shopping in Walmart? No, because there's choices. And so when you go in there, you want a certain thing, correct? And so you're chosen and you're set apart because there's something in you that's purposeful that God needs to do with you, right? So if my testimony is that I was abused when I was 12 years old and I lost my virginity at 12, I can speak to someone who lost their virginity, right? But someone who hasn't lost it until they were 36, can they talk to me? Can they understand what I've been through? No, so I'm chosen and I'm set apart. And so I had to look at it differently because I was ashamed. I said, listen, I'm the cute girl. I'm not going to get saved to tell people that I lost my virginity at 12. Because that's not churchy, right? The churchy thing is to say I was a virgin all my life. Didn't have sex till I got married. But that's a lie because the enemy tricked me. And when he came in, like we talked about open doors last night, there was an open door that happened at 12 years old where I was rejected. I was rejected by church. And so the first thing I turned to was what the enemy said to me. And he said, well, if the church doesn't want you, I'll take you. Right? And so he started bringing people into my life that would tell me things that weren't true. And so he even used people close to me. So he used my dad. So I told you I didn't grow up with my dad, right? Are y'all staying with me? Okay. I'll squeeze you at the end. I didn't grow up with my dad. So when he came in my life, he taught me the wrong things about love. What do we know love to be? Before I tell y'all the wrong things, let me see if anybody knows. Love is pure. Very good. Come on. Love is patient. Oh, she's going to the scriptures, y'all. Come on. Selfless. Yes, love is selfless.
Spiritual.
Y'all got the right. Now, how old are y'all? Some of the people that answered. 19? 17? So at 19 and 17, they have the right idea about love, right? I was 12 and I had the wrong idea. So when my dad came in my life, he taught me that love was won buying gifts. Because every time he came around, guess what he did? He bought me gifts, good gifts too, y'all, real good gifts. It was like Santa Claus. So I said, if he loves me, he's gonna keep buying me gifts. So I put that in my love me list, okay? So I want y'all to keep up with my love me list. What's the first thing in there on my love me list?
Gifts.
He buys me gifts. Ooh, I see like eyes rolling. People in here getting gifts already. The second thing, the second thing he taught me was breaking promises. So I would sit on my front porch and he would say he was coming and he never came. Or he would call and say he was on his way and he never came. Or he would tell me, we're going here next week, get ready. And I would get dressed up and I'd be in my brother's face like, I'm going with my daddy. And he never came. So I said, if he's my daddy and he loves me, and he's breaking promises, this has to be love, right? So what's the second thing in my love list? And what's the first one?
Gifts.
Anybody ever attest to that? You don't have to raise your hand. But you have people that broke promises in your life? Yeah, we attribute it to love. So I have two things wrong in my love list already, right? And I'm not even 12 yet. So my third thing was, well, I said he buys me gifts, he breaks promises, and the third thing was, is a trophy. So my dad, to this day, y'all, pray for him. He still has a thing, because he thinks, you know, he's suave and debonair, that he always has to have a new wife. So he gets a new wife, like, every few years. All right? See, I'm telling the story, because he's my dad. I don't know about y'all dad. So every time he would come around, he would show me off to his new wife. And now, I'm thinking, thinking, this is so cool. I'm a trophy. This is love. This is the best thing in the world. And he would brag on me. He would say how beautiful I was. And he had gifts on me. So I was like this little treasured princess doll walking around. But I thought it was love, right? So y'all can tell me anything. So what's the third thing in my list? A trophy. Anybody ever been a trophy? Ooh, don't raise your hand. I know how it is in high school and middle school. You want to be a trophy and that football player likes you or that baseball player likes you. And now you're a trophy, right? So the three things, see when I start seeing eyes rolling, I know y'all are thinking. The three things that I learned about love that were wrong at 12 years old was that he was supposed to buy me gifts, right? Give me another one. Great promises, or what else?
Trophy.
And so guess what happened the first time somebody did all those things? He loves me. Yay! Y'all was looking at me crazy, but that's what I thought, right? And so what did I do? When he said, I love you, and I thought he did because he did all those things, right? What am I supposed to do for him? What did I think I was supposed to do for him? Uh-huh, and how do you love somebody back? What does the world teach us the way to love somebody back? Sex. Oh my gosh. Nobody wants to say the word. Sex. Yes. Right? Nobody wants to say it. Y'all didn't want to hear the Christian girl say it on the office chat. I'm probably going to burn up. No. You can say sex as the world is saying it, right? Beyonce's saying it. Would she come in here and be like, I'm not going to talk about sex? No. She don't come in here in a cat suit and do something else, right? Come on. Is that the truth? So at 12, I did it. A 16-year-old gave me those three things. Broke my, bought me gifts, treated me like a trophy. He was the basketball star. And at 12 years old, I lost my virginity. I lost my very virtue. My inside, my nature, my little girl, I lost it in 10 minutes in someone else's bed, and it was the worst thing that ever happened to me. And so, how did I get there, right? How did that open door happen? I had a mom, I had a dad. I wasn't looking for it, right? But it happened. Because the open door comes in through the enemy. And so my mom didn't talk about sex. She was in church. So we don't talk about sex. It just doesn't happen. You just don't do it. You pray for it to go away and it goes away. It doesn't go away. Right? And so at 12, I wasn't even looking for that. But because the door was open and I had the rejection, it came in. So I'm going to teach you guys about open doors, because when a door is open, spirits come in. Right? Some people were talking last night about rejection, about bitterness, about pain. So it's not, the surface is my dad didn't treat me right. He didn't love me. That could be my excuse. But that was an open door for other things to come in. And so at 12, when you lose your virginity, who do you tell?
Nobody.
You don't tell your parents. You don't tell anybody else. I didn't even want to talk about it. And the 16-year-old dumped me 2 weeks later, y'all. Can you believe that? After I gave up all I had to give, he left me. Right? But he wasn't there for me, was he? He was there for that 10 minutes of pleasure. Because I know we're going to talk about sex later, but what are men? What do men do? They have male body parts. What do their body parts do? They give out or they give in? What do men do? Men give out. Come on, y'all. I know y'all talk about sex. Men give out. Right? But we take what? In. Come on, ladies. That's basic. We know time. Right? So we're going to do a quick demonstration. I'm going to be the man. Come on. Give me a couple girls. Anybody stand up. You don't have to do anything extra. Come on. Give me like three or four girls. Yeah, clap for it. There you go. Clap for it. Okay, so I'm gonna be the boy today, y'all. Look at my belly. So, we talked about men giving out, right? So I'm this macho man, and I see this fine girl. I'm like, hey, girl. I like your glasses, girl.
And the way you braid your hair, that's real bad. You like the way I said that, right? I know. So here's the thing. We're out of school next week. You know, I don't really have much to do, but you can come over. You just want to watch a Netflix. I got all the new stuff. We don't have to do anything. We just gonna watch movies. I get some popcorn. I'll even take you home before it gets too late. You think you wanna come to my house? Think about it. You know you turn it down. Yeah, I don't think you should turn me down. Trust me, this is the best thing that's ever happened to me. Trust me. Okay, yes, she's gonna do it. She's gonna do it. Okay, so now you're behind me. And so we go and we Netflix and chill, right? But then the movie's over, right? And it's kind of cold. So I'm like, you want me to get a blanket? You know, because it's cold, right? So we're gonna sit here on the couch. But man, this couch is lumpy after a couple hours. You know what's way more comfortable than a couch? Oh yeah, let's go to the bed. Only because you suggested it. You know, I don't want to be too forward, you know. So let's just go to the bed, we'll lay there, watch another movie, and I'll take you home right after the movie, all right? But guess what happened, y'all? We have sex, right? So now, I let her go because that was Tuesday, okay? So now it's Friday, and I need something to do for the weekend. Hey, girl. That Batman movie's coming out. And I've been watching you all week at school, and I just figured, you know, you like Batman. So do I. You can be like my Catwoman, all that stuff. But you know I'm not forward, and I know you're a good Christian girl, so I don't want to mess with you or nothing. So I just want to go to a movie. Can you do that? You want to go to a movie? Why is that so cool? So we get to the movie, and there's nobody in the movie, right? So it's dark, and I'm like, hey girl, let me just put my arm around you. Just for a second, all right? Then my arm moves. Wait, let me just pat your leg, because your leg, you look cold, right? Now I'm rubbing your leg, because it's cold in the movie theater. Yes, it is. And then, girl, why don't you rub my leg, because I'm cold, right? So now we're touching each other, and then I lean in, and I try to get me one, right? What am I trying to get? A kiss. Oh, y'all got it. So we in the movie theater, and we got to go quick, right? Oh, we got some movie theater people in here. Don't tell on yourself. So, we gotta go quick because the lights are gonna come on, right? Don't laugh too hard, y'all might tell on yourselves. So we have a little quickie in the movie theater, right? And you get behind her. So now, this is only Friday, and I've got two soul ties, right? But now this next girl doesn't even know anything about it, right? Because I met her, you know, 20 miles from my house at the gas station. So she doesn't even know about these soul ties. Y'all tracking? Mm-hmm. Okay. Hey, girl. I saw you pumping gas. I just want to add a little $5 to it. Is that good? Yeah, but you're, yeah! Look at you, that was only my $5. Y'all pray for her. Somebody got $5 so she don't get it from the gas station man. Okay. I'm sorry. Okay.
Sorry.
No, where do you live? I'd probably, you know, just make sure you get back home safe because I'm a good guy. Just follow you home. Make sure you're good. Are your parents home? You should tell me where you live. Trust me. Look, I'm being safe. There's crazy guys out here. Just let me follow you home. If your parents aren't home, it's real safe. Trust me. You let me follow you home? Listen, I'm going to be out here begging for you, but I'm saying you're pretty and trying to follow you home.